Welcome to a new journey. Today we'll be taking on an adventure to create the best kingdom Minecraft has ever seen. We will be using the Minekolonies mod to create a fully autonomous kingdom where we are the king. Here are a few rules that we're going to be kind of putting in place to make this more interesting and to make it actually make sense and work. So rule one is if it can be automated by Minekolonies, we will be using Minekolonies once we are able. So what that means is, if I want to automate ore generation and I want to have, infinite iron and all of that, well, I'm going to need to use the miner from Minekolonies. And the next rule is going to be once there are guards in the city, the guards will need to defend the city by themselves. So what that means is you can equip the guards of this mod and they will fight off mobs that attack. And there's also raids that, barbarians or other, entities from the mod will come and try to attack and kill your citizens. So once there are guards in the city, I will not defend the city by myself. And rule number three is every building will need to make sense and be connected in some way. For this, we really need to use paths, make waypoints, which is something that exists in the mod, to really make the city all come together. And I don't want to just put random things in random places just because, it might be useful. I want to make this a massive kingdom. So using these restrictions, I believe that we can really make, a massive Minekolonies kingdom. So, what is Minekolonies? Minekolonies is a mod to where you start with four citizens and you can give them tasks and they will do what you ask. So for instance, we will get four citizens and we will say, hey, you become a builder. We have to build a builder's hut and then he will be able to build other schematics for us. It goes off a schematic system where we pick a blueprint and we will be able to use that blueprint to kind of keep a theme across the whole city. We might switch themes in like different districts or, whatever that, time may tell on that. But for the most part, we'll kind of stick with one theme. And then using all of the different buildings and at Minekolonies, all the different huts and buildings and systems this has in place, we will be able to really make something special. So we're gonna get started here. And as you can see, we're loaded into the world. I just generated it. The only thing I've done is kind of change some configurations. So one major configuration I have changed is, of course, with Minekolonies. I have made it so you can have a 250 chunk radius claim once you get it that big is the cap. And also I made it to where you can have up to 500 citizens. So there will eventually be 500 citizens in our kingdom. With each of them will have a purpose and a job and it's going to be awesome. Another few changes I've made is I have the Better Days mod to make Minecraft days twice as long. I kept the night length the same. I didn't shorten or lengthen the night, but I may change that over time. So those are really the main things that I have changed. Few other mods that we are running here. I'll kind of take a quick scroll through the list, but we're running Epic Fight, Iron Spells, backpacks, all the iron chests and shulker boxes and, mob grinding utils, like all of those things. I don't know what we're going to use and what we're not going to use. I put stuff in here that I thought won't be overpowered, but might be able to be used in conjunction with Minekolonies. So like I didn't want to put refined storage or applied energistics in and use a digital storage system when I'm going to be trying to use the warehouses for Minekolonies for storage and so on. So all that out of the way, we are going to get started. So the first thing I want to do is we start next to some structures, so we're going to need stuff. Minekolonies is a very resource intensive mod. So we start off near some little structures, so we're going to take a look. What is this? Any entrance? Right here. Climb up here. Ah, this is from... It's either... I think it's from Apotheosis. Get these gems. These gems are actually really, really useful. Let's go ahead and grab all of them. Got some unique gems. Alright, and I do think... You know, we're going to want to snag some of this stuff while we can. You know, especially books. Books are always needed. Okay. Oh, there's a chest here under the bookshelf. Well, I'm glad I broke that. Ooh, and we get some starting gear. Got a bow, some enchanted books, and a little bit of iron. That's huge. Let's see if there's any other chests hiding under these. Lanterns are always nice, too. Nice. I'm pretty happy that we started with a bow already. And it's a... Apotheosis bow. It has, like, modifiers on it. Alright, we are playing on hard difficulty. I'm actually going to grab the chest. Sweet. Alright. Let us leave this... little tower. So I have a couple early game goals. Goal number one is just kind of get, you know, established in the game. Get, you know, basic tools, resources, and then I want to move to creating the colony. If I would create the colony, like, literally right now, it would really be just a nightmare. No idea what this treasure is. Got a little armor stand with some leather boots. Take those boots. Give me my hat back. There we go. Starting to get some stuff. Let's venture upwards. So we have amethyst. Okay. I really want amethyst, so I'm going to take a second and break some of these logs, create a crafting table. Oh, okay. There is another secret thing. Maybe turtle helmet. Gives armor, mana, spell power. Okay. This gives armor. Yeah, I think we're going to stick with the iron one. That is pretty cool. I mean, sticky pistons, never know what you're going to need to craft with. So, okay, let's turn our planks into a crafting table. We're going to just get a wooden pickaxe. Oh, wait, we can go straight to iron. Can you get an iron pickaxe going? Just like that. Because I want to collect, these amethysts. One mod we are running is the epic fight mod, because I just think adding those animations is really cool. Okay, I think I'm also going to craft an axe with my other three. So I can use that as a weapon and break all these bookcases and logs and such. Having this many books is going to be very nice. I think I'm not getting some of these amethysts, which is okay. Alright, climbing up here, we got this inscription table from the Irons mod, some beds. Snow, ice, some more loot. Oh, we got a weapon. And we're already running into the classic Minecraft mod problem. I think I'm just going to put all those books in there. I don't think I'm going to need them. But I will take a few more of the actual books. Okay, so lanterns. I'm just kind of looting random things right now. I just do not know what I will need and not need. I think we could probably ditch the cyan carpet. Now, this building looked a lot taller. So I'm actually going to pillar up. I'm going to see if they're hiding something. Break a few more logs. I need to get some light in here. There we go. I'm gonna fill her up. I know I've played mods in the past where they hide stuff in like the ceilings of these towers. But I don't think that's the case. Okay. With mine colonies, there is a item called a supply camp or supply ship. These are actually really easy to make, and they give you like a nice little starting home. Now, I am not a builder. That's why I love mine colonies so much, is I am not a builder in this game. So it's going to give me the option of having, you know, the colonists do the building for me, and I can just do the planning and all of that. So we're gonna make an exit from this tower. You know, this tower starts pretty far up. I've just noticed. When I look up here, why does it start up here? I bet there's something hidden underneath. A necromancer? I don't have any food. This, you know, this could be death. But, I think we might go for it. I do not know what to do. We have some spell scrolls already. Okay, that's huge. And some food. Just quickly. Some food. That is some good food. Okay, paper amethyst shards. My flower pot's back. Okay. This is a big development. Ender pearls. Okay, what are you? Don't think I'm going to care about that. Ender pearls, some lightning in a bottle. This is quite the start. I didn't put a seed in. I didn't, you know, I just kind of started a world. So I'm pretty happy with this little starter area. I almost broke an anvil. I might grab lots of ink, enchanted books, hellfire. I don't really think we care about. Mob chance to drop spawn eggs. We might grab that. Smite one. I don't care about smite one. I don't think I care about either of those either, but I will take capturing. Some pants. We can get those on. Already getting like a full set of armor. We have emeralds in the wall. What else we got? Now the necromancer disappeared, and I'm wondering if he is like outside now, or maybe underneath. So we're gonna take the spell scrolls. Are they the same? Ray of Frost and Frost. I'm wondering if there's like something under the carpet or under the snow, or like another. Oh, there we go, another hatch. Okay, what is down here? Let's get this trident out. I think that's going to do more damage than the axe. So we have a bunch of wheat. You know, we got some food. There's like a prison cell. Tripwire hook. It's supposed to be like a little faucet. So this seems like an ice mage. Alright. How can we make a backpack? Because I'm already in need of a backpack. From the sophisticated backpacks mod. So we need leather. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to do that yet. So we have a frost wave, level 2 common, or level 5 rare. Frost step, that sounds quite nice. I think we're going to ditch one of the beds to grab frost step. I don't know what is on this, but we're going to find out. Potion of instant mana. Don't think I need that right now. I think I would rather click these havens. What do I... First saplings can go away. Okay, well, seems like a pretty good start. I'm gonna check underneath again to see if maybe there's more. Does not look like it. I think we hit at the end there. But now this necromancer, I'm worried he's gonna be like outside. We do have armor. have a weapon. We got a trident. Let's take a look. If we see him and we can't take him, we're just going to run away. So I do notice a mob on the map. There he is. Is he coming for me? Oh, that is not... Okay. Run. We are running. Don't forget my keybind. There we go. Switched into the... Okay, he's summoning polar bears. We don't want anything to do with that. We are out of here. There are now tusk boar things chasing us. I'm running. Get to the ice. Okay, well, besides almost dying, that was a pretty good little loot run. Is this a village? Oh, heck yeah, we might have just found a village. Take shelter in the village here. Perfect, I'm gonna set my spawn on that bed. And now maybe we can make a supply camp. Nice, village. Where are the villagers? Oh, I hear him. Hello, villagers. Some furnaces. Okay, so to make a supply camp, you need chests. So I need wood for that. So let's... Oh, there's another one of those little towers there. Let's come to this tree, chop up the wood. I think it needed a decent amount of chests. Five. Alright, let's throw down those saplings. Get that out. Gonna need to make a crafting table. Man, modded Minecraft and inventory is always the most fun. Alright. Let's make chests. So there's four. And five. So now if we take chest, supply camp. Awesome. And it is turning night, so let's find a bed. Should be one over here so I don't have to place the one I have. Oh, the necromancer. He has followed me all the way over here. Maybe we'll see if it'll let us sleep. Even though the necromancer's right outside. I don't really want to use one of these scrolls, because I think if I use one of the scrolls, they're just done. But I don't have enough wood on me either. So let them break this. Okay. Calm down, somebody pull over here. Okay, crafting table. We need food. We're gonna take on this necromancer. We need food. Get some bread. Sleep through the night. And then we're gonna fight this guy. I don't know why it just said Tempest Fugitive. Alright, polar bear. Summon polar bears down. Where is this necromancer? He might have left. That might have been what that Tempest Fugit thing was. I do not see him. Villagers, there's a cat. Okay, we're gonna hope that he's gonna just leave and leave us alone. Alright, now we need to set up our supply camp. So I really want to set it somewhat near where we're going to set up our colony. So let's take a look. Just kind of run around for a little bit. See what we can find. No, I didn't loot that tower over there. I don't have any inventory space. I will come back to that. But ooh, there's leather. Oh, there's leopards. Let's see if they will just leave me alone. Okay, well, I got some leather. I think that might be enough even for a backpack. So far, very lucky start. That is a massive beast, okay. That was a whale. Okay, so I want to find a place that goes through multiple biomes that is not just super flat, but also isn't mountainous, because it's really painful to build in the mountainous areas. And I want to find a place that we can grow, have a massive kingdom on. Like, I don't want to pick an island, but then the island, you know, won't be big enough for the 500 chunk, or I don't remember the exact number of chunks they can get to. I think it's 250 chunk radius. But I don't want to pick a place that's just super boring and flat. Like, this place, cool, it's flat-ish, you know, it seems big, but right, it looks dead. It's a tundra. I'm not a fan. Okay, I was just seeing if the RTP command was in here. It is not. RTP is a random teleport. Those are grizzly bears. I don't think I want to be near them. So we need to walk through the bed, sleep through the night. So I'm not too worried about that. I really want to find a nice place to set up. Okay. We're going to kind of turn. I think I see another village on the map. Southeast. This place will be... Oh, is this an abandoned mine colony over here? This might be one of those abandoned mine colonies. Take a look, there's a horse in the stables, there's cobwebs around. Horse is dead. Oh, they're dying to these little bushes. Let's help them out. Alright. What is in here? Just got some more bread. Okay. Definitely looks like an abandoned village. A shield? We will take that. Spruce logs. Don't really like that. Oh, I threw my trident instead of using the shield. I think the trident is just gone. Okay. Well, that stinks. Stay back. Anything to loot in here? Nope. Well, it looks like it's just a ransacked village. Nothing really to worry about. There's a cat in there. I'll let you free. Cool, we got another structure over here. Ah, this one looks like one of those mine colony deserted things. Which would be cool, because that will allow us to grab some of the starter blocks we'll need. Yeah, with the shingles and everything, I think this is one of them. Is this a mine even? Yeah, it is. Alright. Oops. Okay, it is not worth waiting to break those. It said, please find the town hall to find out what happened here. Okay, we have another big structure. Lots of structures. Is this the town hall? This is the town hall. 15th day of harvest. Do you want to reinstate the settlement? No, I do not want to reinstate this settlement. I do not like this location. I do want to go check that out. So this will start kind of slower, we'll be honest. I've played through the start of Minecolonies a few times, so it does start off a little bit slower, but once you start to get, you know, buildings going and you have a couple builders and some, you know, all of those things, then it really does start to take off. This looks like a barbarian camp style of thing, so I think I just heard some illagers, pillagers, whatever they're called. I don't think I'm ready to take that on yet. There are just towers everywhere, things everywhere. Really want to find a place to settle. So I'm going to keep running around, trying to find a place to settle, and then I will be back once I do. Actually, there's a massive structure. Oh my, are those copper blocks? Hold that thought. We might be spending some time here. That is a lot of copper just on that building. That could be good for like just early game material. I don't know if that's the copper you can actually use or just the decorative stuff. Curses. Don't know if we want to try to tackle this. Is this just block of copper? Wax block of copper. Can you do anything with this? Okay, you can actually use the wax blocks of copper. I'm gonna just take a few. I'm gonna make a waypoint. How do I do that again? Waypoint. New. Copper thingy. I will come back to this. Okay. So now I'm actually going to take a second, run around for a while, and find what I think will be the perfect place to set up. So I will be back. Okay, we are back in the area that I think we're going to be setting up in. So it's really not that far. It was probably just like a 1 minute of running, honestly. But let me show you why I think this will be the dream spot. So number one, I saw how the land kind of looped around, you know, completely of this icy area. Strange sound. And then this biome here, this is all massive, and then it keeps going. So I really like the idea of having like a city that is surrounding, you know, surrounding water and having like buildings on the edge. The only thing I'm wondering is this like an actual biome that stuff will keep freezing? Or is this kind of just here? It is a frozen ocean. Look at that insane looking structure over there. Okay, I'm not as sold on this as I was. But we can like cut the ice down and like that'll be fine. You know, we'll get probably that layer of ice on the top. But what is over here? So this is a crazy looking area. Okay. Don't know how much we can do with this. But everything else we can definitely use. I think it will be a good place to start. There's a bridge going over here too. There's something on the map up here. Okay. I think this is where we're going to start. I'm not going to build a colony today. So I'm going to think on it. If anyone has opinions, please share the opinions on, you know, if they think this could be a good spot to set up and eventually turn into a massive kingdom. Like, I'm not against going into the snow area or, you know, going down here, there's more green biomes, more taiga looking biomes down there. But for now, I'm going to kind of pick a spot out of the way, because I don't want the supply camp to be like in the village, in the kingdom. So I'm just going to put it out of the way. That way it's somewhere close by, but it's not going to get in my way. Okay, so now this is the style selection for the colonies. Right now it doesn't matter because I'm just placing the supply camp. So I just want to pick a supply camp that I think will, you know, be the best starter. I think the cavern one might be. Place supply camp. I think the cavern might be the best one. Because it gives you a lot of, you know, all of these racks are storage space. It does give some ideas on like how to build the cavern. Let's see what the upstairs looks like. Okay, so it does have like automatic furnaces and stuff too. I think we're gonna go cavern. You know, and when we break this thing down too, we can get all these resources from it. There is a one supply camp limit. Let's see, where can we place this? Right up here, that'll work. So you can only ever place one supply camp. But once I place this, that's it. I can't like farm these for resources. Spots down. All right. Break this couple trees. It's not going to be perfect, but this is just a temporary house. It's going to be kind of floaty in some way. But this also gives you an idea of how the placement for the mine colonies mod will work. Let's bring it over here. Let's take a look. I think that's fine. It's not really going to be too floaty. And again, we don't really care too much if it's floaty right now. It'll give us ample storage to start out with. You know, the auto cooker furnace. Recheck the highlighted blocks. Oh, is it? There we go. I think it was a little bit too far down. So, what about searching it? Okay, I don't know why these still say need air above. I'm hoping that will go away. But let's take a look at this house here. So again, this has a bunch of things and tips for if you're going to be doing the cavern style. I'm not sure what style we're going to do yet, but it starts out with saplings of every type, some wooden tools, some lanterns in the town hall block, some basic food, and upstairs this is going to start us out with some more wheat, some melons, pumpkins, and an architect's cutter. Okay, these are really useful. And a little game auto furnace. So put fuel there, smeltable there. Okay, those things did go away. So this is really cool. It is indeed a little bit overpowered with the start, but once you guys see how intensive this mine colonies mod is, I want to jump straight into it, so I don't care, you know, that I'm using this little bit of a cheesy start here. So I'm gonna get my inventory put away. I'm not really gonna sort stuff right now, I'm just gonna pick a rack and dump. Really only need to keep my food on me. Is there the sleeping bag? There is a sleeping bag, and I did notice there's some wool up here. we might take a little chunk out of the ceiling here to make us a sleeping bag. I think it's two. No, it must be three then. Or we'll replace it with something. Pots back up. Okay. Is there a crafting table in here? I'll have to craft my own crafting table. Okay. Grab a piece of wood. Crafting table. Right here. Sure. Oh, that's perfect. Let's change that. Go right here. And we can make our sleeping bag. That way we don't have to carry a bed on us and change our spawn, so we can set our spawn here. Our bedroom, and we now have this starting home. So, I don't really know what style we're going to do, but we can kind of scroll through some styles here. And kind of figure out what we want to do from there. This isn't where I'm going to place the town hall, but we are at least going to get the schematic up. So, switch pack. So, up here we have all of these Nordic spruce, you know, the caves, jungle treehouse, medieval spruce. So, we want to go for a kingdom feel. Fortress. This could be one. Every monarch dreams of having a perfect capital city where it's clean organized. You know, that could be it. This is a beginner style. Serves a lot of the essential blueprints to raiders, miners. Okay, not really feeling a simplistic one. Medieval oak. This one does kind of look like a castle style. Medieval dark oak. Shire, desert oasis, pagoda. I'm kind of feeling medieval dark oak. It's intermediate, I think. You know, a new castle emerges. So let's take a look. Fundamentals, town hall. So it looks like there's two options for the town hall. And you can see them at each level. So I just popped this one up as the level 5 town hall. So that does look pretty cool. And then we have this option, which looks, honestly a lot less cool. I think the alt town hall, level 5, that's going to be cool. Is that going to take a lot more resources? Heck yeah. But, and we'll look really cool. I think the colors are going to go with this biome really well. Let's go ahead and sleep real quick. Okay. So the colors will go with the biome really well. You know, those dark and kind of the purplish of the brick with the kind of darker mossy colored grass. I think that's going to look really good, but now let's see what it's going to look like at level 1. So level 1, this is what the, oh, okay. Am I getting my first death here? We took him out, barely. Alright. Flashing. Alright, flashing stopped. Okay, so this is what level 1 would look like. We don't need all those resources at the beginning. Pretty much just looks like we need a bunch of wood. Which we can do. So there's that option. So I'm kind of feeling that one. There's Nordic spruce. I don't think I've ever seen this one. So there's only one option. That's the town hall. Nothing. A level 5 town hall should kind of look a little bit fancier than that. Let's take a look at medieval spruce. Oh, there are two options. I like it when there's two options. Okay. So are these like gates? Oh, there's gates. There's like towers. This one might be the one to go for. You still have those darker wood colors, but this one feels like the proper castle. I like. What does the regular look like? Yeah, we definitely go for the alt. And then there's medieval oak. Let's look at fortress. I think fortress is weird that you have to like connect things together. Yeah, there's these little slits, and it's supposed to just be like one massive compound. I'm not really feeling that. I think I want some more freedom of where to place things in. All right, and then medieval oak, medieval birch. I'm not a big fan of, you know, the light colors of the birch wood. So let's look at this, fundamentals, town hall. There are two options. So we have the alt. I think the alt is the cooler ones. I like that. Ooh, that is nice. That's really nice. There's the nice gates, just like the... Okay. What's the regular one look like? Yeah, we go alt. We go alt all the way. Okay, so I'm between... the medieval oak and the medieval, where was it? Medieval spruce. They're both rated as intermediate. So I don't think that either of them would be too hard. They'll probably just need tons of wood. So I think I'm just going to leave it there. If anyone has any opinions, you know, please share them, and I will go off those opinions. But one down, we got a nice start. You know, this little starter shack will be really nice. And we're going to start by placing our town hall, getting our first citizens, and really starting to grind out the resources for whatever style we choose. So thanks for sticking around on this first one. And again, leave your opinion on which style we should go with, and I will see you in the next one.